Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. How are you? If you can hear me, please write in comments. If you can hear me clearly, please write in comments. My name is Asavari. I am Fevicryl Hobby Ideas teacher. Today I will be showing you a mosaic painting style. This is the lamp we will be making. Hello Indu ma'am, welcome. So this is the lamp we are going to make today. We will use some different color combination and the design also. This looks like a Turkish style lamp. We will be using a pearl kit, fevicryl pearl kit for this. You can take an empty glass container, any glass jar you can take. I have taken this cheese glass jar, empty cheese glass jar this was. Like this it was. And now we can hang it. Okay, I'll try to speak louder. Sugandha ma'am, thank you so much. I will speak louder. Inside this lamp, you can put a candle. You can light a candle and put inside. It transforms the colors. And these Turkish style lamps are in bright colors. Actually, in Turkey, in Turkish lamps, they use glass pieces and they stick over it. They also use metal. But this is a DIY, so we are going to replace the materials. We will be using paints for all these, for decorating the lamp. This is the rope you can see. Any decorative rope you can take. Only thing, see that the rope is strong enough to hold the glass container. So let us begin. I'll adjust the camera. I will show you the materials which I'll be using today. Yes, so here are the materials. This was the glass which this was the lamp made earlier. Today I will be using some different color combination. This is an empty jar I have taken. It is a cheese spread cheese jar which I have taken. Like this. Now we will start with how to draw the design on it. Because it is a glass, everyone must be thinking how to draw the design on it. I will show everything. Let me tell you which materials we are going to use. We will be using pearl kit because it's shiny. We want to give that shiny effect. As this is this workshop is related to festivals, we will be using these lamps for the festival purpose. So some shiny things I am using. Pearl kit. A gold color and this is a silver color. Everything from fevicryl we are using. All the products are available in UAE. In design you can draw, you can check on Google about the Turkish designs. You will get to know many designs, and either you can draw directly on a paper or you can take a printout and later you can trace. It's up to you what you want to do. Hi Savita. So here is the design which we are going to make today. I have kept a paper inside so the design will be visible clearly. This is the design I'll be showing today. You don't have to keep a paper inside. I'm just putting it for the clear visibility. And this design I have drawn, and we will be making that design here. How to make that, I'll show you now. Let us start. So this is the same design. A smaller piece is here. We have to decide the location where we want it. Now you can see here I have drawn a line, white line is there. Black line I have drawn. On that line I am arranging this design on that black line. I have aligned the design to that line. This is a blue tag. With blue tag I am sticking it. Now the design will be visible clearly, and we can trace it with the help of permanent marker. Take any permanent color permanent marker, but better to take a marker which we are going to highlight later on. So here I will be highlighting black marker, so I am taking black marker and start tracing the design. Yes, Indu ma'am, I'll speak louder. Thank you. While tracing the design, adjust your glass jar according to the design which you are tracing. Don't just keep the glass jar on one place. Keep rotating the glass jar. You can choose any design. Today the design which we are making in a traditional way, they cut the pieces of glass and then they stick it. That is called mosaic. Putting different shapes together is called mosaic design in simple words. As this is a permanent marker, the marker will remain on the on this glass, and even if you touch there, it will not go. So don't worry about that. Try to draw all the shapes of same size. Now are you able to hear me, Indu ma'am? Yeah, so I'm tracing the design. Those who have joined late, I would like to tell them we are making a Turkish style mosaic painted lamp. We are painting it on a glass jar, empty glass jar. This is a recycled This is a recycle activity. So here I have traced the design. It is written with the earphones, it is audible. So if you are not able to hear me, please use earphones. And I am trying to speak louder. Okay. Now the design is drawn here. I will keep this paper inside so the design will be visible to you all. Because of the transparent glass, it is becoming difficult for you all to see. So with this white paper, now you will see what I am doing. I hope the design is clear now. Now this is the design. I'll continue here. You can draw the design directly. It's not necessary that you have to trace, but the shapes which I wanted the same shape everywhere, so I have traced the design. Thank you, Payal. The remaining design which was not drawn here, I am just drawing it directly. There are many designs on Google. You can check the designs. Just search for Turkish lamp designs. You will get lots of ideas. We are going to create the same effect using Fevicryl acrylic colors. And on the Turkish lamps, you all are aware that the colors are very bright colors they use. And when you light it up, that lamp reflects all the bright colors. It looks very pretty after lighting it. Now there is a mistake here, so I can erase it if I want. Even if it is a permanent marker, if you make any mistake, you can erase it, because this is on glass we are drawing, so you can erase it easily. Hi, Ai. Thank you for joining. If your jar is big, then you need to draw bigger design. My jar is very small, so this only one circle was enough for me. We will be using pearl kit for coloring on this. Fevicryl acrylic colors. Pearl kit it is. So it will give nice shine. It takes more than 1 hour to finish the full jar. So what I have done, I have traced the 3/4 of the jar. I have completed 3/4 of the jar, and now I am showing you only 1/4 part, because it takes more than 1 hour to finish the full jar. So let's begin. I will start with the center part, which is blue color. I'll tell you the name of this color. This is pearl blue. These all six shades are available here, and I'll be using two shades from it. That is pearl blue and pearl green. These two shades I will be using from here. You can take small size brush because the design is very small. As you can see, it's not even 1 centimeter design. So this is 1 number brush and 0 number brush. You can choose as per the size of your design. Now what is this at the back of this brush? This is a small sponge, 1 inches, 2 inches square sponge. I have attached it to the brush with by using a rubber band. We want to give a glass look to it, so we are doing this. Glass pieces look. I meant we want to give this glass pieces look, because on the traditional Turkish lamps they use glass pieces here, or they olden times they used to take precious stones. So to give that effect, we are going to use this sponge. This is a blue color, pearl blue color. I'm not taking any water. I'll start with the center part. Yeah, if you are not able to hear me, then please wear a microphone. Please use microphone, then you can hear me clearly. Earphones you can use. Now I'll show you closely how it looks. I'll give a. Let me finish this, then I'll show you. Now when I'm using brush, it will leave some design on, it will leave some gaps in between, and it doesn't give a glass effect. This doesn't give a glass piece effect. To give that effect, what I'll be doing, I will take with the help of this sponge which is put at the back, I will just dab it over this paint. So it will create some texture. And once it dries, it looks like it is a glass piece stuck over it. It will give look like this. Once it dries, it will give look like that. Choose bright colors. Then when you light it in the night, when you light it at night, that gives nice effect. Colored light will get transformed from it. You can color 2-3 petals and then you can dab the sponge over it. To save the time, you can do this way. Instead of dabbing after one petal, you can togetherly 2-3 petals, you can give this effect. Now wherever I want to give blue color, I will finish it at one stroke, then I will change the color. If you are from UAE, then in Global Village we get to see this Turkish, in the Turkish pavilion we get to see these Turkish lamps, and they are very expensive, yet they are very beautiful. So everyone wish to have it. So this is the cheaper way to make it by yourself and enjoy doing it. Get the pleasure of doing it by yourself. We buy honey bottles, they are of glass. Cheese bottles are of glass. So instead of throwing them, make use of them by decorating in these ways. And this is a glass jar, so there is no harm in keeping oil lamp in it or candle, or you can use this battery to you how you want it. Are you doing it with me? Any of you are doing it with me? You can write in comments. Hello, Jyoti ma'am. Can you hear me, ma'am? So I did four shapes, four diamonds together, and now I am dabbing the sponge over it. You have to dab a sponge before it dries. Before the color dries, we have to give this finishing. Either you can hang a rope or you can use it as a jar again. It's up to you how you want to use it. If you want, you can use it as a container also. Decorative container, you can keep anything in it. Okay, ma'am. Later on you do this, and then please tag us. Post me the photos how you made it. I will like to see it. Yeah. Now I'll start with the other color. It's always better to finish with one color and then start with other. You can take the same brush or you can change. I'm going to take the same one. With the sponge only, I am dipping it in the water and washing it. No problem in it. Be careful, this color is wet, so just be careful. The same technique I'll be using. Give color in 2-3 shapes and then dab it with the sponge. That will save your time. If you start painting directly with the sponge, the color might go out. Here there is less possibility of that. That is why we are painting first with a brush and then we are dabbing it with the sponge. Every week we are conducting workshops. Each topic is different. So take out the time and try to attend. When you make something, then we post us the photographs of it. You can post the photographs directly on the group or you can send to us personally. Looking at your work, your article, other people also will get inspired. So do post the photos, whatever you are making. Beautiful shades of fevicryl colors are available. So do try different color combinations. This design is intricate, so it takes little time to do, but the finishing look is very beautiful, so you will not regret spending this much of time on it. For this, I have not given any base coat. We are just doing it directly because we want the light to get transformed from it. If we give base coat, then the light won't transform. It will become opaque. You can try using glass colors also, fevicryl glass colors, but its look will be entirely different. Those colors are transparent acrylic colors are not transparent, so the effect of both will be different. So one you can make it this way, other you can make it that way. You can try. Be careful while placing your hand because the colors are wet. It doesn't take much time for the colors to dry, but now it's not even 10 minutes, so this side colors are wet. As you can see, I'm not dipping the whole brush, only the tip of brush you should dip. Invite your friends who are interested in art and craft to join this group. Don't leave any gap in between. Try to cover everything. Even if you cover the black line, no problem, but don't leave any gap in between. Now I'll show you how to do this circle part. For that we will take other color combination. Wash your brush immediately so that they last for a long time. Now let me show you. See, this part we are going to do now. I'll show you how to do this. Okay. For this circle part, I'll be taking silver color, this is in tube, and blue color, which was in pearl kit. Mix it. I'm going to mix little blue in it. Even if it doesn't mix completely, it's fine. Suppose little bit is not mixed, it is like this. If you don't mix it thoroughly, then also fine, it gives different effect, nice effect it gives. Now this portion is little, the width is big. So I'll be doing this directly. You can do like this with the sponge. Those who have joined late, I have attached a sponge here, a very small piece of sponge with the help of rubber band. You can attach it on brush, on blue, what is that, toothpick, or you can attach it on earbud. Here I want to use brush and the sponge, so I have attached it on the brush only. So no need of changing the material all the time. These pieces were very small pieces, diamond pieces, so we didn't do this technique directly with the sponge. First we colored it with brush and then we dabbed the sponge over it. But because the width of this circle is little bigger, I can do it directly. You can cover the black line, but don't leave any gap in between. Black line can be drawn later on. Once the color dries, we can draw the black line. Thank you, Anagha. Those who have joined late, they can watch the video later on from the beginning. If any doubt is there, you can ask me in comments, or later on when you are making, that time you can ask me personally on my Facebook page, Creations Unlimited. If you feel anything is wrong, you can correct it immediately before it dries. Share the video with your friends. They can also learn new techniques. They will get inspired and they can create their own, they can add their own ideas to it and create something new. After finishing look, after we give finishing look, it will look properly. Now the look is like this, but later on when we give finishing touch, then it will look great. It will look exactly like this. So let's start with the next step. Now I'll be taking this gold color. This is not available in pearl kit. You need to buy it separately. Now I am taking little bigger brush. This is 4 number brush. We will give this effect to it. Let's start. Now here again I'm just dabbing the brush onto the glass jar. We'll give projected effect, embossed effect, because as I told you, it should look like these pieces are stuck over it. It should not look flat. That is why we are using this technique. Now this center color, only this outer part is not dry. This will give it the beads look. You have stuck beads over it, or you have stuck some glass pieces or precious stones, like that effect it gives. See, this way. We will be giving final touch up also. These were just the guidelines which we have drawn using black marker. We need to give finishing touch also. Anagha ma'am, can you please use earphone, then you can hear clearly. So this way we have finished with golden on the top side. On the bottom also there is golden paint. We have to be careful where the color is wet. Don't touch there. Now only sticking the rope, that part is remaining. Actually when we stick rope, we have to keep it at least for half an hour without touching it. because this rope is going to hold a heavy glass jar, so it has to be stuck properly. This gold color is in thick consistency, so when you dab it over this glass, it gives that embossed effect on it. It looks like you have stuck something on it, and we want that effect. Here I have, by mistake, gold color has come here. I will check it later on from where it is removed, and then I'll give it back there. Yeah. Now we will paint this blue dots. I think these blue dots we can paint later on with the same technique how we did gold color. I will show you how to attach the rope here, because you must be thinking how it will hold the glass jar. So let's start that. For this you will need a rope and fevicryl fabric glue. You will need, this is a fevicryl fabric glue, this is a rope which I am going to use. Now first decide the location where you want this, so which part is wet, that side I will avoid. Mark the center. I'm using this marker. Apply glue over it. Apply generous amount of glue, because this rope is going to hold your glass jar. So apply generous amount of glue. After you apply glue, then take a masking tape or any cello tape. Cover it. We have to remove it later on, but just for the support I'm using this masking tape. On the end of this rope I have made two knots so that this rope doesn't come out. As you can see it here, I have made two knots. Because of that knots, this rope is not coming out from here, from this part. Now we have to keep we have to apply a rope on the edge of this glass jar. I'm applying glue on that. Start from any point. It will take half an hour. You have to keep it for drying. It doesn't dry quickly. It takes time. It's simple, I'm just going round. Go over this row. And continue again. On the rope also you can apply a little glue, and once it is stuck it will not come out because there is a knot here, so don't worry about that. Now what I'll do, I'll attach the masking tape here like this, wherever I have finished sticking. Anagha ma'am, now are you able to hear me? Now am I audible? Am I clear now? Okay, keep going round. Again, on this also we have to apply glue on this. Once you come here, then again attach the masking tape. Now when you are rolling one more time, then touch the glue to the rope and to the glass bottle. Both the places your glue should be touching. Now again I am attaching the masking tape to it. Yes, yellow, orange, red, that is also acrylic colors from the same kit. It is from the same kit. See, my golden color was not dried, so it is coming down. I have to redo the golden color later on. I'll just show you this because this is important. How to hang is also important. The same tape I am covering again and again, no problem. It is just for the support. Later on we are going to remove that tape. If you want, you can add more tapes also. At least 4 rounds are needed to cover this part, as you can see here. And once it dries, it can hold your glass jar. No problem in that. But don't use the normal fevicol. Use this because we are using the rope, that is thread. So use this fabric glue. I have not tried with fevicol. I have tried with only fabric glue, so I can tell you for sure it will stay. I'll give one more line. It's the pot is almost done. Only thing that orange was not dried, so I need to redo it, but that I'll do later on. I have shown you almost all, I have shown you all the steps how to get this look, Turkish lamp look. Take a generous amount of glue . Do make these lamps for Navratri, Diwali, or any other festival, Christmas, Eid, and post us the photographs of it. Now my top of the jar lid is covered with this rope. So I have cut this off. Now again, what I'll do, I'll apply glue on the end of these, the beginning and the end. Like this I have done, and leave it here for drying. If you want, attach more masking tapes. Add more masking tapes so this stays forever. Wherever you have placed the rope, it should stay on the same place. That is why attach more masking tapes for time being. After half an hour, you can remove the masking tape. Same thing I have done for this one. Now this golden color later on I need to give again, which was at the bottom here, at the lower part. And it has gone over to this light color which was given, light blue color, so I have to redo that part. Anyway, I'll do it later on. Once it will finish, it should look like this. So what we will do, we will have to give outline again, black outline again. We want to give finishing look to it. So if this part is dried, then we can start outlining it. It's up to you how much thick line you want for it. Now see, this is the part I am doing. So this is the first look, and then after I finish doing, because there is a glare, light glare on it, so maybe it's not clear to you. I will take a close up and show you. I'll take it to take it close to camera and show you. Yes, I am giving black outline with this black marker. I am using marker. Indu ma'am, I am using marker now for outlining. We need to give finishing touch. The colored pieces are stuck over the glass, so there is this there will be the gap in between two pieces. That's why we are using marker. We are not taking the liner, fabric liner we are not taking, because we want to give this effect that the colored pieces are embossed. Color pieces should be projected out. That is why we are using this marker. We don't want to project out the outline. Black outline need not be projected. Are you able to see the difference after giving outline? It looks finished product looks better than before. This is a simple permanent marker. See here, this was how it was before, and after outlining this is how it looks. So when we will complete the outlining for the full jar, it's going to look very beautiful. Of course these tapes we are going to remove later on. And as you can see here, blue lines are there. They are nothing, just how we did this gold line, same way I made the blue lines also. If you want, I'll show you little part I can show you. I will be completing it later on. This is how we have to go. There is a diamond here at this part. Diamond shape is here, and there is a diamond on the top also. We will remove the tapes later on. It will look like this once it is complete. Thank you, Jyoti ma'am. Do try it. We're waiting to see your finished product, finished article. This is not complete yet. Finishing touches are remaining. This is how it will look. This side is complete. Once it is dry, then I can remove the tape. There is a masking tape to support the rope because this lamp is going, its lamp is heavy, glass jar lamp, and the rope needs to be fixed properly. Thank you, Ai. So here it is. Do join in next week also. I'll post what we are going to do next week. I will make a poster and forward it in this group. Please invite your friends to join the group if they are interested in craft art. This color needs to be dried, then only I can do the outlining. That part I will do it later on. See that your rope is in the center. We have to mark the points and there only that rope should stick to be fixed. It will take some time. So thank you for joining me. See you next week with another art. We Fevicryl expert teachers are conducting different live sessions for you, so please join and also try to make it by yourself and post us the photos. We would really appreciate. If you have missed the previous workshops, I would like to tell this is what we made. This is from the glass plastic milk bottle. We made it last week. This is from the milk bottle which we buy here, plastic milk bottle. This also we did it in the workshop. Thank you, Jyoti ma'am, for this also we did it in one workshop. This is made from newspaper. This video is there on this group, Facebook, on this Fevicryl Hobby Ideas group. So do check that and make it. There was one workshop on glass bottle painting. This we have done in the workshop. And many more workshops are coming up. So stay tuned with us. Thank you. Thank you, Indu ma'am. So this is what we did today. This will take little time for drying. I cannot do it in hurry, but final look I'll post to you very soon. I'll post it in the group very soon. So bye for now. See you next week. Enjoy the weekend. Bye.